I think good things can happen.
How important is this entire candidates and world championship cycle for you? Because when you play, let's say, against Magnus or someone at Speed Chess Championship or any other event, it draws such huge numbers in itself. It's an event of great magnitude. So for you, what does this entire cycle mean?
I mean, I can give you the answer people want to hear or the true answer. I mean, the true answer
would be great.
I mean, I think what I would say is it doesn't matter much to me. I think I've said this quite a bit recently. You know, when I look back over the last couple of years, I don't think there's anything that I can accomplish as a chess player that will matter as much as the impact I've had as a streamer and a content creator specifically. So for me, a lot of this is just very much a sort of like gravy on top of everything else, or, you know, sort of having your cake and eating it too, where, you know, I'm just playing, trying to do my best, but ultimately it doesn't matter that much to me because my main focus, of course, is on content creation. It's bringing chess to the masses. And so I try to do well, and I think ultimately that also helps me a lot more because most of the other players have a lot more riding on the candidates specifically than I do financially and otherwise. And so I think I use that very much to my advantage, that I don't have these same pressures that most of the other players have to deal with.
I interviewed your wife yesterday, Atusa, and she said that there's something that really gives you a lot of energy, that is the fans who write and you know, who are interacting with you. Does that really make you feel special? It gives you a lot of energy?
Well, I mean, I think one of the biggest drawbacks, I would say, as a top player playing chess, I mean, I can say this from having played so many top tournaments, is that when you go and you play tournaments, generally there are a handful of spectators, maybe 10 spectators, a few journalists, and that's about the extent of it. And I think when you play some great game, great novelty, win a game, and, you know, a few people notice it, it feels very strange. You feel like you've done something remarkable, and then there's no one to really celebrate it with. So I think having the fans sort of cheering me on, knowing there's so many people who are rooting for me, it makes a huge difference. And I think that also, playing for a bigger audience, playing for more people than just myself, it also means a lot. And I think the audience that I've cultivated online, they all are supporting me. So it's been great.
And Hikaru, the 6 months left for the candidates now. As you said, you have so much to do. You promote chess. You were also in a TV show recently. We got to know it was a US show.
Billions, I think.
Yes,
probably.
Billions.
Yeah.
So there's so many things happening at your end. How do you manage it all now with also the candidates in the...
Yeah, I mean, I think that's why actually I pick and choose my tournaments very, very carefully. I don't play endless chess tournaments specifically for this reason, that like if I were to try and play a tournament every month, I wouldn't be able to do it because I would get too tired. And so I try to plan my schedule very carefully for that reason. And I only play tournaments where I think I can give it my best effort. And honestly, this year I played a few more tournaments than I would have liked. I wasn't going to play the World Cup originally. Then I played that. Then I had to play in the Qatar Masters. Also wasn't going to play that. And then I played here. So it's really a matter of picking and choosing the tournaments. And I feel like if I have a couple months between events, I can still put in the time to prepare and get ready. But if I were trying to play every single month or even every week with all the online tournaments, I think the quality of my play would suffer, and I think that's the reason actually quite a few of the top players have sort of fallen off a little bit in recent times. So I just try to balance it, and so really looking forward to it.
Lastly, I want to ask you, I interviewed Caruana, who said that you are at the peak of your chess career right now because the way in which you are living your life as well, you are in a very good place in your life. Would you agree with it in all aspects, not just streaming, but also your personal life and so on?
Yeah, I think the simple answer is I don't have any problems. That's the simple answer. So it's like, you know, there's a saying, you have 99 problems, but, you know, certain things aren't one of them. And I feel in general, I don't really have any problems. I'm just enjoying every aspect of what I do. And I think whether it's playing the tournaments here or there where I try to give it my all, whether it's streaming, you know, or obviously my personal life, like it's all very, very positive. I think when everything is positive, everything's going well, it's much easier to perform.
Thank you, Hikaru. It's inspiring to see you in action, managing everything. Really, hats off.
I do what I can.